Hi, I'm Nicholas. In this video, I'm going to show you how to enhance motion capture data using Control Rig in Unreal Engine. First of all, thanks to Noitum for providing the Perception Neuron version 3, which I've been using for both traditional motion capture and driving real-time characters in Unreal Engine. The purpose of this setup is to enhance the accuracy from the mocap suit when using a two-handed prop like a sword, and by also keep part of the left-hand rotation from the mocap data. We're going to use a MetaHuman, and inside its animation blueprint, we're going to use a live link node and a control rig. In our control rig, create two controls as child of the root joint, using the name IKHandL and IKHandR. Then set the transform using the HandL and HandR joint, so that the hand animation coming from the perception neuron suit will be assigned to these controls. Then get the hand L and HandR location and use the vector length node connected to a remap node. The idea is to get a min-max value that can tell us when the hands are close enough when using our sword, so we save the results as a float. The rotation offset of the right hand has been added to avoid clipping of the 3D sword with the head. Then create the HandR control offset as a child of the HandR, with some offset in order to have it centered on the hand. Create another control as a child, which is going to be the left-hand position, and give it a bit of vertical offset. Outside of the skeletal hierarchy, create a control called HandHell control offset and a child control, with the same offset used for the right hand. Next, use the HandR control left offset to drive the HandL control offset. Now get the XY rotation from the right hand and get the HandHell Z rotation and mix them. By doing so, the left hand follows the rotation of the sword handle, but is using the HandL Z rotation from real-time motion capture data. Then set the HandL control offset rotation. Finally, use the basic IK node to drive the left arm, using the HandL control for the translation and the rotation blend created before. Use the IK alpha to drive the weight with a bit of smoothing using the average over time node. Inside the character blueprint, add the 3D model of the sword. In this case, I used a sword from the Infinity Blade asset. Add it as a child of the body and make sure it is attached to the HandR socket, and eventually adjust its transform so that it will be near the palm of the hand. While testing the setup, we can see that the left hand, as soon as it gets close to the right hand, its position and orientation are driven by the controls we previously created, but we notice that the rotation around the handle is given by the left hand rotation. Debugging the vector length and remap node, we can see the threshold where the left hand and IK alpha kicks in. This solution can save quite a bit of time during motion capture cleanup, and it can be used with various two-handed props, and it can also be useful for real-time characters, since all the data is being taken care of in real-time by Control Rig.